Hello, everybody. How are you? Oh, let's take that down. The stream has started. BJ and Robin here. So, welcome to our second live stream here from Castle Blackamore in lovely Cranston, Rhode Island. So, tonight, I'm going to be singing a few tunes. Robin's got a few awesome pieces to read. Aunt Tina down at our feet here might make an appearance, or Pug. And then we're going to hear from some of our closest friends and amazing musicians and writers. We've got Evan Gavry joining us in a little bit. And we have Gray and Fallon joining us. Gray Bouchard's going to be reading, singing some of his amazing tunes. Fallon over from Stranger Stories.
Stranger Stories. One of our favorite local literary happenings.
Yeah, tell us a little bit about Stranger Stories. You read at a couple of their events,
I'll leave it to Fallon. All right. Because she'll do it better.
Deal. And then Stev DelMonico is going to be back from last time, from the Quahogs. And we're going to close out with Mary B. Then Robin and I'll probably close it out with a tune or two. And then we might have a special surprise guest pop in at some point. So hang tight for that, all right? So what we figured we'd do is I'll start with a tune or two. And then Robin will come in and she'll read a piece or two.
Yes.
And then we'll get right into it. How's that sound? Ooh, look, Carolyn's here, Gail's here, Dave's here. What's going on, guys? All right, I'm going to start with a song called Flares.
Static like a weary mountain pass, off to kiss the fading spark that kept drifting through the cracks. If I took it all, post beams and slats, and with it all the questions that we didn't want to ask. Oh, saccharine whisper sent the stars to sleep. Oh, a thousand falling faithful like a shepherd and her sheep. Oh, constellations forming all eyes and teeth. And she was selling off her diamonds for the sun played for keeps. Oh, 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 she went like flames, surging scars through the atmosphere. And wore the bottoms out, chasing after verses as they all came down. She went off like flames. and scars through the atmosphere. And I wore the bottoms out, chasing after places as they all came down. I was chasing after verses as they all came down. I was chasing after verses as they all came down. I was chasing after verses as they all came down.
So that's a tune called Flares. How's everything sounding out there, guys? Give me a little feedback. Oh, well, thank you. Thank you very much. Hey, Lee, what's going on? I see that Evan's coming in shortly. So, I'm going to move on to a newer tune. In the last live stream, I gave a sneak peek of this song that we recorded over at American Bull Studios with our good buddy Bruce Pierce. I'm going to play it live today. It's called That's All Right. Hold on.
Whispers slip through tired windows. The clouds are chased them in. The floorboards take a beating, and they bark right back again. Oh, how the winds are growing stronger, like the howling of wolves. What's empty will stay empty, what's full will overflow. We were wrong this time, and that's all right. Yeah, that's all right. Watch the pines in the backyard like a country's front line. They'll fight into the darkness. Your guess is good as mine. We could forfeit every acre, the forecast singing in the wind, or gamble on the thunder. Just a warning shot in the end. We were wrong this time, and that's alright, and that's alright. We were wrong this time, and that's alright. Yeah, that's alright. Paint falls like sheets from the clapboards. The chimney smoke charges a fog, then washes in. Voices through the haze are burning bright for days, while the light bulbs in the house are burning dim. We were wrong this time, and that's alright, and that's alright. that's all right. Yeah, that's all right.
That is, that's all right. All right. Speaking of all right, I think it's about time for us to hear from Robin, yeah? Ready to read us something? Slide on in here.
Ooh, hi, everybody. I was talking to our secret guest. I'm seeing if he's available to us, but we'll see.
Ooh.
We'll see. Maybe very soon. Maybe after this poem?
Sure.
He needs to come in earlier, you know. People are home with their kids. I am going to read something. I didn't really keep track of what I read last time. So if you heard these last time, you're in for a treat. You'll hear them again.
I only have so many songs.
I don't think I read this, but...
It's a good one.
Feel free to heckle me if you'd like to.
Oh, I'll heckle you.
Not you. I was talking to Evan. He can heckle me. I see Carolyn, or she could do it. Lee's too nice. I don't think she'll do it. this is called Taking the Long Way on the 4th of July. At sunrise, after talking for 8 hours, I asked about your most prized possession, the object for which you're most known, and you described in great detail the beauty of uncovering rust in the forest and bringing it home. At sunrise, after talking for 8 years, I asked about our unfinished plans, and I described in great detail the sadness of scratching the surface, digging for answers, last on your list of repairs. I think will we see him if he pops up?
Yep.
I think he's gonna. Okay, so
yep,
we'll see him. Okay, let me just tell him to join us.
I am going to. Oh, there he is.
There he is. All right.
No, that's Gray.
Can they both be in there? Is that okay?
Yep.
Hi, Gray.
Tina wants to make an appearance.
This is our pug, Aunt Tina.
This is Aunt Tina. Tina smells bad.
She's a beautiful lady.
Oh, there's Evan.
I'll read a little tiny one. And I wrote this in secret using my phone as a light at the opera where they don't allow you to have a light or a phone or be me there. And it's called...
That one time we almost got thrown out of the BSO.
That is... There are certain places that I don't belong.
Likewise.
But I still try to frequent them and see how it goes. At least I'll get a sad poem out of it. This is called The Falcons Leading the Hounds. 100 out of 100 times, you said you would choose to take the chance and gamble on me and all 967 miles. But what's the over-under on how long I can act right? Don't cry, honey. You know how it ends. They either get married or they die. Aunt Tina sees a dog outside. This is why she can't attend our live streams, because she does not know how to act right.
Oh boy.
Not here, not at the opera. She just knocked over a cocktail. It never barks. This is new to us.
Hang on, TT. Oh boy. She'll settle down.
I don't think our special guest is in here.
Well,
yet, but
we'll maybe see if he'll pop in right after we talk to Evan, because it's about time for
Evan.
Let's talk to
Evan. Aunt Tina.
That way we can mute ourselves while Aunt Tina settles down. What's going on, Ev?
Hey, y'all. What's going on? Hey, y'all. What's going on?
Can you hear me? How are you?
I'm doing okay.
Yeah, we can hear you.
I'm doing okay.
For those that don't know, A plus on dog commentary.
Mm-hmm.
For those that don't know, Evan is down, or... Captain Bunny Dangerfingers, as I should say.
Yeah, crash landed here.
Down in North Carolina. New Orleans. How's
not
New Orleans?
It's not north of much.
It's not north of much. Nope, it's north of the Gulf.
Cuba, maybe.
So how you doing down there?
I'm doing okay. I've been working at the grocery store, so I'm keeping stupid busy.
Yeah.
Been watching a lot of rig rundowns.
I know, we were texting back and forth in the middle of the night, Angus Young's rig breakdown.
Oh, you wait, I sent you that one. You got to watch U2 from the the U2 one, man. The Edge guy traveled with 30 guitars.
I was good, and he's got like a rack of pedals. Yeah.
No, it's his tech is crazy. He's whatever he played on the record on that song, he travels with. Insane.
Oh man, we'll have to watch that one at sometime around 2 a.m. our time. And we'll text back and forth.
So I've been getting my two amps running in stereo and rewiring my pedal board so everything is stereo and like these crazy long delays. It's insane.
Because of the rig rundowns?
No, I was doing that before. It's just really accelerated that process.
Has Tina settled down?
She moved out.
She moved out. Perfect.
I actually got it running right now, but I don't know how it'll carry over just the laptop microphone. Hang on a second. I'll play it a little bit. Let's see if you can even hear it.
Oh, boy.
So, yeah, rig rundowns and Metalocalypse. That's what's been getting me.
I love it. I love the light show you got going, too.
Oh, always. Yeah, yeah. Well, I got to overproduce everything. Always.
There's a reason we do these live streams, and this is the reason.
This is it.
Yeah.
This is for us, no one else.
Yeah. Audio geek stuff.
So you want to play us a tune or two, bud?
Yeah, definitely. You want to hear a cover first or an original?
Let's start with an original.
All right.
I'm going to kick myself out here. Captain Bunny Dangerfingers, everybody. My buddy Evan from down in New Orleans.
All right. This is a song of mine about those things that you can't give up doing, even if they hurt you, which for me is music, which is, you know, for other people, it's other things. And it's timely with the murder hornets in the news because it's called the Hornet's Nest. And the backstory to this is my favorite toy when I was a little kid. My first instrument was a snare drum. And I used to just sit in my yard and I didn't know how to play drums. I just hit it and listened to the reverberation across my yard. But I used to keep it in the garage. So one day I came back to it and there was a bee's nest in it and I couldn't approach it anymore without, you know, getting lit up by the bees. So it took 30 something years to percolate in the back of my brain, but this song ended up coming out of it. So. The sound when I was young, like a hornet's nest and marching drum. Ain't nowhere to play it, boys, without getting stung. But the thing you want is always gonna hurt you some. I grew up, I tried to make my way out in the world. I raised my share of cane and I chased my share of girls. It came time to walk that line, you know I tried my best. I can never shake the sound of that old hornet's nest. Oh, mama, won't you pray for me? That hornet's nest won't leave me be. Papa's in the barrel house, mama's in the church. Neither one can tell me if I am blessed or I am cursed. There's a buzzing in my head, and I'm like a damn about to burst. gonna strike that tune with all I have and let them do their worst. But mama, won't you pray for me? This hornet's nest won't leave me be. Not as strong as I used to be. This hornet's nest would be the death of me.
That's the hornet's nest.
Nice, man. I love that song.
Thanks. That's great. This is my dad's old Gibson. So, you know, he gets a mention in the song and playing his guitar. So that's a nice little vibe.
Love it. So I miss our days of touring because Evan plays like 16 instruments in every show.
Can't help myself. I just got to keep adding stuff to the pile. Every gig I load in gets longer and longer.
Everybody walks around and says, oh, this guy can play this. Throw it in the van.
Mm-hmm.
Bring it with us. So you're going to do a cover for us?
Yeah, I'm going to do I'm going to swing over to the keyboard station here. And I can fit it in.
Exactly. And,
this is I learned it off a Bonnie Raitt record. I forget the guy that wrote it. But it's Bonnie Raitt made it famous, and I've been playing this one a lot, but I haven't actually played it in front of anybody, so this is sort of a debut, and see if I can get through it without crying because it's a sad song. All right, here we go. I've had bad dreams too many times. Think that they don't mean much anymore. Times have gone and left my sad home. Friends who once cared just walked out my door. Love has no pride when I call out your name. Love has no pride when there's no one left to blame. I'd give anything just to see you again. I've been alone too many nights to think that you could just walk through my door. Heard them say it's crazy to stay. This love hurts me so. I don't care what they say. Love has no pride when I call out your name. Love has no pride. There's no one left to blame. But I'd give anything just to see you again. If I could buy your love, I'd really try, my friend. If I could pray, you know my prayer would never end. If you want me to beg, I get down on my knees, begging for you to come back. I've been begging for you to come back, hoping you'll come back to me. Love has no pride when I call out your name. Love has no pride when there's no one left to blame. Well, I'd give anything just to see you again. Love has no pride when I call out your name. Love has no pride when there's no one left to blame. Well, I'd give anything just to see you again.
you have it.
Yeah.
Do anything to see again. That's the takeaway.
You can see us here.
Missing everybody right now. Yeah, no, it's great to see people sharing music and poetry, and you know, it's good to be in the salon with the creative people again. It's I'm going a little stir crazy on the soup aisle of the at the grocery store.
It gives me something to have insecurities about all week, so I like it.
Right.
Gives me something to worry about when I'm.
Well, and I'm in a different time zone, so I was over here. You know, the same thing as the last time. I was over here plugging stuff in and sound checking, and I was like, "Oh my God, it's 7 o'clock there already."
Yeah, we were trying to remember if we fed the dog at 7 o'clock, so that's why we're a couple minutes late today.
You said you liked the light show. I was going to have a costume, but you caught me half dressed.
Next time.
Yeah.
You got one last one for us?
That's all I had in mind. Let me think for a second. What tuning am I in? That's the other problem. Let's see. What have I got on this? I always like this.
That's fine. You can drink it.
Well, here, we'll do this one if... if Noel's watching, I'll do a dead cover. Just give me a second to tune this up.
I know Dino was watching.
Yeah. You got a deadhead in there somewhere. I guarantee it.
I'm so worried.
Just give me a second to tune this up.
We're going to be here tomorrow.
Close enough. Operator, can you help me if you please? Get a ride, carry a load and tell me what that I need. Singing like some other dream. Think she's somewhere down about that. I just can't let it fit on the door. Distance connection. That's all we got right now.
Oh, I love it.
And I'm the operator.
I gotta get some of requests in for next time we do this.
Yeah, definitely. So, help.
I want to hear a Long Letter Home. I haven't heard that tune in a long time.
Oh yeah. Yeah.
Or any Kenny Rogers song. I want to continue this stream cycle.
Oh yeah. The last time we talked about just dropped in. I do want to learn. That's, you know what? That's the stereo rig.
I wouldn't mind hearing that.
like stereo rig.
All right, buddy. It was so good to see you. Thanks for popping in.
Thank you,
everybody.
Sir.
Captain Bunny, Dangerfingers.
Looking forward to the rest.
AKA my longtime buddy, Evan. Thanks, bub. I'll talk to you soon.
All right.
Bye. Yeah. All right. So we've got a special guest backstage, huh?
He's here, he's hiding, he's ready to talk to us.
And he's handsome.
He is very handsome.
Look how handsome he is.
Oh my God, it's Brian Oakley.
It's Brian Oakley.
Hey, can you hear me?
Oh yeah.
We can hear you great.
All right, great.
We can hear you, we can see you, you look great.
Cool. Thanks for having me.
Where are you?
I'm in the kitchen. This is my kitchen. You guys are in the chapel. That ding is the Grubhub order. I apologize.
So for those of you that don't know, our friend Brian here is the head of the team behind the amazing Pizza J and Julian's here in Providence.
Woohoo!
And he's popping in to tell us about PMA today. What's that all about?
So PMA today is a very casual 15-minute interval of me talking to people that I think are awesome and inspirational in our city of Providence. Format is basically like, hey, how does this pandemic affect you, your family, your work, your teammates? Maybe let's talk about something that's inspiring you to keep you positive. The whole premise of the show is to keep a positive mental attitude, right? And then a track.
It's hard to do right now.
Well, if you're not laughing, you're crying, right?
Yes. Yeah. It's turned into a life of extremes.
Yeah. Right, Billy Joel all the way. Yeah. So, on this coming week, we have two special guests. We have Kendra Plumley. She's going to show us how to draw a shark on Thursday.
Ooh.
Kendra's a local artist, very prolific, also been working with Julian's for over 10 years. And your very own Robin from around Red Fest and social media and the arcade and Trinity and a million other things.
I do
talk about the great thing that is around Red Fest.
I will. I will tell you all about it, and hopefully we'll be able to host another one of those in the future.
I know that you're hosting some format or another, so I'm excited to hear your thoughts.
We've been tuning in, and it is it's a real breath of fresh air because it's nice to just see some friends online and smile. And the other cool thing is, like, we learn about people in our community and the things that you wouldn't typically know that they did, which is it's fun to get a little deeper into knowing the folks that you see pretty often around town.
Well, I feel like you in particular, DJ, are somebody who should be on the show because there are a lot of anecdotes that I hear your name attached to.
Maybe we don't need to hear them.
Yeah. Don't put them on a pizza because they won't sell.
Right. But I'm looking forward to our 50th episode where it's rumored that we will be performing a live marriage between the two of you.
That is true. We are considering it. We're not sure if we can get a marriage license right now. I don't know what's open and what's not.
Well, everything opens June 1st, so you should be okay.
So I'll be at least third in line down there at the marriage license at beautiful Cranston City Hall.
Well, I think we can wait till at least June 2nd.
Someone's getting worried. Right. We spent a lot of time together here in quarantine. So both of your restaurants are up and running right now?
Yeah, they're both up and running doing curbside pickup. We have decided to refrain from outdoor dining for the time being. We want to make sure that we do it in the most thoughtful and safe capacity that we can execute. And we don't feel organized enough yet to do that.
Well, there's just so much change going on. It's good to take an extra second to kind of learn how to do it right.
And, well, we have two things that we live by. Typically, one is that when the tide rises, all boats rise. Mm-hmm. But the other one is that food service is the first line of public safety. And so I know that everyone's in a huge rush to get the economy open, and that's very important. Obviously, we need to make money to pay our bills, pay our team. But it's also important to us to not only keep us and our team safe, but to keep you safe. And because basically when you want to eat, you're saying, please don't poison me, right? You know, so, and also the experience of when you go out to eat is also very important. So how do we do this in a way where you're excited and good about the entire thing, you know?
Yeah, we miss coming in, obviously, but we know that you are doing the right thing.
Yeah, and you know, you guys have gotten super creative in what you've been offering to go. You know, one of the first in the city to start doing to go cocktails. And I remember day one, we're like,
we need that.
We need a mimosa in our life. So we drove over there and picked up the mimosa kit, and it's just it's been nice. You know, for all the trouble that and stress that I'm sure this has brought onto the industry, it's been nice to and almost exciting to see folks like you be so innovative in how to have fun with it and stay positive about it and still service the community around you. So we both applaud you for all that you're doing for the community and for being so creative and innovative and keeping things going strong.
And we love how you love your team. You love your people, and we love that about you.
Yeah. They're good. They're all good folks. And with the cocktails, I know I don't have a lot of time here. You have a lot of guests. The last guy was awesome. Yeah. You know, with the cocktails to go, a big thing with us is that, like, we don't want to sell you a cocktail that is watered down. Which is why we're doing them most of the kids the way we're doing it. It's a carbonated beverage, and we don't want it to be flat and get to where you're going. So we don't want to drink in your car, right? And the same with our cocktail at dinner program. It's like everything is served neat, so it's already been shaken, filled. If you get home, you want to put it on ice. That's up to you. We just want it to be a good product, and we feel good about serving it.
We feel good about buying it.
Yeah.
So look, I'm gonna let you go now. I really appreciate having me. You guys are awesome.
Oh, so nice to
see
people
that I really like a lot.
I know we invited you to this about 6 minutes ago, so thanks for joining us.
All right, I put a shirt on. Have a nice day.
Say hi, Kristen, and say hi to Kristen and Wyatt for us.
I will. I certainly will. But in the meantime, I want to just say to everybody, this is Tuesday. If you go to Instagram Live at PTJTV, we're going to be having Robin at 7 o'clock. We're going to be talking about all things vegan, all things positive. And we hope that we see you there. And BJ and Robin, thank you so much for having me. And be safe and keep doing what you're doing. You guys are great. Thank you.
We love you. We'll
love
see you on
buddy.
Tuesday.
Thank you so much for being here.
See you Tuesday.
Have a good night, all.
See you Tuesday.
Bye.
Oh, it's good to see Brian.
I know. I love
him.
Me too.
All right. So
he works so hard. We really admire him.
We really do. He does a lot for the community too, that that's in the background that you don't even notice sometimes.
It's true.
So I think Gray's backstage. Want to say hello to, there he is.
Hi guys.
What's going on?
Oh, not so much. Sweating it up in this little sweat box I set up for myself.
Same.
Yeah.
It's warm in here.
The people next door are having a great time out in their backyard having a barbecue, so like they're having a lot of fun. So I close.
Do they have more than 5 guests?
No. They're
all right.
Responsible.
Keep an eye on them.
Maybe that's who our dog is barking at.
I would snitch.
I will turn in anyone.
Anyone. My mother.
I would like to leave my house again and feel good about it someday.
I know.
Barbecues are ruining our summer.
The beaches and barbecues, man. The bees.
I would rather have nothing.
Take it all from me.
I love it.
Yes. Yeah, so Gray has a band that he can tell us about, and we met him from Fallon, who is...
I'm going to bring Fallon in. She just joined us. Fallon, are you ready?
Yeah.
There she is.
Oh, look at that face.
Hi. Oh, it's so good to see you.
Hi. Gray and I are
I'm
divided right now.
It actually, as this is set up on the screen, is the relationship in the house. Yeah.
So for those of you watching that don't know, we are live streaming here with another couple who is in the same house, and they do two different things. One's a writer and one's a musician. Hmm. So they're going to join into our live stream tonight.
Yeah. And we're actually in their living room.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We're in our own house. I wish we were over there.
Almost 3 people.
That is, no, we're close.
We're really excited. We're like, when do we ever get a chance to be on the same platform together?
Yeah, we never would. So we invented something.
I feel like we should do this. Yeah, we should like steal their idea.
You should do it. We will tune in.
We will gift it. You don't even need to steal it.
You guys can appear on ours.
Yeah, we will.
Perfect.
Even if you didn't invite us.
All right. So I'm going to kick Fallon and Robin and I out of here, and we're going to hear a couple tunes from Gray. All right.
Right on.
See you in a bit, Fallon.
Bye.
That was so abrupt. Oh my. All right. So I'm going to start here with sort of a newer one that actually most people haven't heard. This is very much, this is totally new. So this one's called From Here To, or From Here To ... So we go like this. Here to infamy, my friends. Walking down a busy street, hearing nothing but the wind. I know we're changing, Yeah, I know we ain't our best. The songs they write uptown don't sound like this. No, no. No, no. Carry me back home. I couldn't make it alone. Sing out, hold out the no. Carry me back home. False sense of confidence, you said. It's half a conversation, I couldn't hear the rest. You think you were born for this? Yeah, you think that you're the best. That part is over, let's start again. Carry me back home. I couldn't make it alone. Sing out, hold out the no. Give me back home. Who's laughing now? The shadows are climbing up the wall. We're losing daylight fast. Keep your eye on the ball. Shameless desire will kill us all. Does the record still sound as good as it did? The grooves under your fingers, soft just like your skin. They say this one's a sleeper. It'll knock you on the head. A boy like you, a girl like this. Then carry me back home. I couldn't make it alone. Sing out, you better hold out the no.
Ooh, yeah.
That was, you sound amazing.
Oh, thank you.
It sounds great.
What a pro.
I try.
You're doing great.
Thank you very much. We got time for a couple more?
Yeah, please. Yeah, please.
All right. You know what? I'll do a song that is from one of the bands I have. So, as mentioned, I've got some bands, I have my solo band, which is Gray Bouchard, and the Dedications. And then I have my sort of loud and raucous rock and roll band, Salem Wolves. And this is a Salem Wolves song, and this one's called Titanium. And I got nothing to prove, at least not to you. It's not so funny at all. Well, you can't wave it away. I've had a nosebleed for days. You can't think through the pain. Yeah, yeah. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh! You met me at the gates. Let
You said it's just a matter of faith. You couldn't look me in the eye, I was cold as titanium. Dark as a dying sun. You could call me a coward, but brave men run. Cold as titanium. I remember you this way. Cut, cut, white lightning. I was mixing codeine with cocaine. I was out of my mind, I was cold as titanium. Raised as a bastard son. You could call me a coward, but brave men run. Cold as titanium. I was cold. So cold. You could call me a coward, but brave men run. Cold as titanium.
I wish I was cold. Hot.
All right. Sorry, I muted us.
Oh, no. It is getting warm, huh?
It's getting toasty up in here.
We were worried about the motorcycles going by opening the window, so we're sweating it out.
It's loud out here.
That's what you gotta do. You gotta suffer for art.
And Castle Sweatbox.
Yeah.
You got one more for us?
Yeah, I think so.
Oh, please.
All right, I'll do another Salem Wolf song. This one's on a record we got out called Tooth and Nail. It's an old one, but I rather like it. It's called.
This is the band you have with Chuck, right?
Yes, this is the band. Yes,
a very nice man. Has a very nice wife.
He does.
Who actually reminds me of Fallon a lot. Liz is very like Fallon adjacent.
The first time we met them.
Oh, there she is.
Right?
Fallon just perked right up.
No, it's so true. They came over last summer for a barbecue, and I just thought, why do I not know this person better? Which is also the same reaction I had when I met Robin.
When I met you, I was literally hopping up and down with excitement. And Gray was like, great. There's another one. I was hopping. I was like vibrating with happiness.
I friend stalk.
I was very excited. Who are my buddy Dan, who worked with Fallon, introduced us. And I think he's in this live stream somewhere watching, but he introduced us, but I would have found you anyway because I was stalking Stranger Stories hard.
All meant to be.
Yes,
it's weird how things work out that way. It's
I know. Look at us now.
Well, so yeah, we'll all have to hang out together once
we're allowed to.
So. Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
This isn't good enough with you guys not even in the same room.
Actually, I think that she's happy with us. With the two of us
and your baby, that will make five people.
Oh, that's true.
Yep. Yeah. Yep.
Sorry, Tina, you gotta go.
No, the pug's not coming.
All right, Gray, let's hear it.
So this is one with that band, with Chuck, and it's called Can't Wait. We live well beyond our means. They say the house never gets beat. They send you packing up to Newark, running from your hospital bills. Oh, 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 I can't wait until. Oh, you could say we were never bored, living higher than we could afford. Every sticky finger bandit got the shooting hand caught in the tail. Oh, 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 I can't wait until. I can't wait. I can't wait. I can't wait. I can't wait. Oh. You got the candle burning at both ends. You're spinning stories to your new set of friends. Well, they can hear it when they're talking, but they'll hang around till they get their fill. Oh, 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 I can't wait until I can't wait. I can't wait. I can't wait. I can't wait. You could lie flat on your back. I see you're on the case. Oh, but madam, I'm an atom looking for an E. Got the snake curled around your waist. Let it never be said you had good taste. But I'm betting you're regretting all the promises you couldn't keep. Oh, whoa, whoa. Whoa, whoa. Flat on your back like an innocent tied to the track, but the train that you've been running just in all of your new set of skills. Oh yeah. Oh, 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 I can't wait until we can go outside. I can't wait. I can't wait. I can't wait. I can't wait. And by that, I mean, I can't wait until I can see you guys in person and do this with you guys in the room, the same room. That'd be great.
I can't wait until I unmute us.
I keep muting us. I don't want to be the person that's like talking over your beautiful song. And I'm like,
yes, that song is beautiful. Beautiful.
Chit-chatting over here. It's a very nice song. I never have seen that band.
Oh. Ooh. We're around. We're you know, it's a little hard to play these days for some reason.
Yeah.
Well, it's good to hear you here digitally.
Thank you guys so much for having me. Thank you.
Oh my God, so much fun.
Thanks for joining us. And, this is a lot of fun.
We're going to do it probably every other Friday.
Yeah.
So
you know where I'm going to be.
Think about joining us in a couple of weeks. We'll do it again.
Yeah, I would love to. Thank you so much for having me. And
it's so fun.
Everyone, you know, I'm very excited to hear Fallon story, probably from across the room. You know?
Yes.
If you're quick, you could run upstairs.
Yeah, actually, you could probably hear me upstairs, yeah. I wish we could work out something where I'm like, hey, honey, do you want a beer? And then, like, it appears on her screen. Oh, whoa. All right. Little tricks. Well, thank you guys so much.
Well, thank you so much, Gray. Appreciate it.
We'll talk to you soon.
We'll see you soon.
See you guys. Thanks.
Fallon!
Hello.
I'm so happy that you're here.
Yes. Me too.
It was so fun to watch your stranger stories, your digital stranger stories.
It's so strange to get into the format of digital for stranger stories.
I know.
Because when we, so if you have, for anyone who hasn't seen the show, we normally our bi-monthly show where people come and share their true stories on a given theme. But whenever we do a stranger stories, we give this whole preamble about don't record it.
No.
These are intimate true stories. And now we're just like, put it on the internet. There's no rules anymore.
Yeah. That's why we've been thinking about doing another. I know you had asked last week, we might do another Little City Love scene. We would be more careful with what stories people read, because they're reading stories. We have another project for anyone who doesn't know called Little City Love Scene, and it's people submit dating stories. A lot of them happen in Providence and or just greater Rhode Island, or Rhode Island transplant residents read them about, you know, other places they've lived. And it's something I really wanted to do for a long time, and people submit stories to us in advance via our website.
Anonymously,
littlecitylovescene.com. And then, much like Stranger Stories, they get read at this event, only we assign them to strangers. So you don't know who's going to read yours. People reading it don't know whose it is. And it makes for a very funny, awkward evening. And no one sees the story until right before they read it. So its delivery is funny. The topics are very weird, racy. And so We wanted to not, just like yourself, we want people to feel comfortable reading it and think, like, this is just a one-night thing. We don't want you to record this or...
And I make you want to help them anyway.
Remove that obstacle so they can go there, you know. But if it's... I thought Stranger Stories was... It did feel more comfortable than I thought it would. So you guys might want to think about doing a little city magazine.
So, we're thinking about... We'll do it if you will read something.
Yeah, sure.
So we our second date was Stranger Stories at the Waterfire Arts Center.
Yes, that was our,
a very big deal for us.
That was our second date, and I didn't know him, and I was real nervous about reading that outrageous story about the treehouse, and I didn't really know you yet either, and I was like, what am I getting into? What am I showing this person? What does this say about me? He showed up, and my whole family showed up, and everyone, my coworkers, like, it was a funny night. And so Stranger Stories is very special to us.
And then you had such a memorable later date, which was a story I got to hear at Little City Love Scene about you guys jumping on a plane together. And so that was a very amazing beginning of a relationship. Lots of adventures.
We talk about this all the time because we love to hear ourselves talk in quarantine. We have no other friends besides people that are tuning in right now, but we love to talk about all the funny, weird things that we've done over the past few months together in such a very accelerated short period of time. Like, we moved. We've been to 10 states in Canada together. We're getting married. We've got a pug. Like, we just are doing, we did Little City Love Scene. Like, we're just doing all these funny things together, and it's been so much fun to meet people like you and Gray and...
Yeah, Stranger Stories holds such a really special place in our hearts. So thank you for doing it for us.
And thanks for joining us tonight. Your Stranger Stories the other night was so beautiful and so much fun to listen to. And you had the woman who had a recurring role on The Sopranos, which is my all-time favorite show, which I feel like dirty saying.
So she was amazing, Marianne Leo, and she has a cool book out for anyone who's interested in Mom Speaks Up. And Robin, beforehand, when we were in the Stream Yard, I was just grilling her about the Christopher intervention scene, because she plays Christopher's mother in The Sopranos. And I was just, tell me more. I can't hide my fandom. I'm such a, I love TV. I love movies. I love gushing over them.
Yes. James Gandolfini is like, embarrassingly,
I'm gonna tell everyone
because it's just us and Fallon. No one's watching. I love James Gandolfini. I loved him so much. I had like a very big crush on James Gandolfini. I just thought he was so mean, and I was like, I don't know what that says about me, but I just loved him. I thought he was so cool, and so that's just such a great show.
So good.
Did she meet the rest of the cast?
Oh yeah. we can't even go down the floor.
I will text you about it. Okay. What are you gonna read for us tonight?
I'm gonna read a piece that I read at the first Stranger Stories. I've never had an occasion to revisit it, so I'm super psyched to get to share it again.
We're gonna kick ourselves out so we can hear it.
Let's hear it.
Great. This story also seemed like a good one to share tonight because it's really captures, I think, nervous energy and paranoia, which seems apropos for the time. Not long ago, I watched my mother berate her boyfriend for packing their car with luggage for an upcoming trip. They were traveling for a week, they had a lot of suitcases, and he'd made one critical mistake. He was packing the car in broad daylight, where anyone driving by could see it. We're on a cul-de-sac, he protested. Who's driving by? Joe, my mom yelled. They're gonna know we're out of town. Anyone, the mailman, the neighbor. I couldn't help myself. Get it together, Joe, I scolded. Joe rolled his eyes at both of us, and it was a sobering moment. I come from a long line of nervous women. My great-grandmother was a perfectionist with an award-winning rose garden. My grandmother laid out her weekend outfits on Monday, checking them each night to make sure none of her kids had ruffled or stained them in any way. But my mother is nervous in an entirely different way. When she moved into a new house 15 years ago, she fretted and paused over the placement of her recliner. Finally, She slid the chair away from her window and into a corner. "Why did you do that?" I asked. "Someone could see me sitting there and throw rocks at me," she said. I nodded in agreement at her sound logic. My whole life, my mother had peppered me with paranoia. When I was little, it was more basic lessons like don't talk to strangers and never get in a person's car, even if they say I'll kill your whole family unless you come with me. And if my brother or I went missing, she reassured us that Paul Alvini's house next door would be the first place she'd have the police check. The advice evolved situationally as I got older. Always carry water. Don't go too long without eating. You could faint and hit your head. If a pharmacist needs your address, pass them your license instead of saying it out loud because a killer could be listening behind you. If you have to run, run zigzag. Look in your rearview mirror when you pull into the garage to make sure no one is doing a military tuck and roll underneath. And if someone rings the doorbell at night, scream, go away. I like to tell my mother she has a criminal mind. But when I catch myself nodding along or browbeating her boyfriend for security breaches or saying, good point, when she asks me to draw the blinds at night in case someone is watching us from the woods, I have to wonder if maybe through the years it's worn off on me. It wasn't always like this. In fact, when I moved into my first non-roommate solo apartment and my mother insisted I install an alarm system, I thought it was a little unnecessary. But of course I went along with it. I was 23. My father said he'd send over his alarm guy, Lou. Now my parents aren't together anymore, but I have to imagine the fact that my father had an alarm guy might have been part of the attraction there. Lou was a wonderful and thorough alarmist. He taught me things that even I, a bona fide paranoid, didn't know. Like how it wasn't enough to just have glass breakers and boop, 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 boop alerts on your opening windows and entryway. You need motion detectors, Lou told me, because criminals don't always come in through your doors and windows. Sometimes they come through the fucking walls. I was horrified. In all the nights I lay in bed, plotting out my daring and courageous escape route in the face of a home invasion, first, I would hide behind the bedroom door and I'd cold clock the intruder with the lamp and then I would escape through the laundry room. I'd never accounted for the fact that the perp might come in through any way other than the obvious. What if he came through the laundry room wall? It nullified my entire escape plan. I knew I had to pass this valuable information on to my mother, who was sitting defenseless in her own home, just like I'd been sitting defenseless in my apartment. When my brother and I moved out, she now lived alone in a two-story, three-bedroom house with many barren and vulnerable walls. I decided to visit my mother the day Lou upgraded her system. He was a bit of a character, a true Irish-Italian Rhode Islander, thickly accented, and my father vaguely advised that Lou was so good at his job in security because he'd walked both sides of life. Lou also had a flair for the paranoid and theatric that rivaled my mother, and I sensed an entertaining afternoon. When Lou arrived, he nodded appreciatively at my mother's many glass breakers and door open, door close, boop, 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 boop sensors. He then began running through a series of tests. First, he hid behind the refrigerator and asked my mother to pretend she was walking into her kitchen through the back door. I sat at the kitchen counter and watched the scene unfold. My mother entered the door and walked down the hallway. Lou, out of sight, lurked behind the stainless steel fridge and got into character, a menacing expression on his face. When she passed by, he leaped in front of her, arms outstretched, and screamed, "Gotcha!" My mother gave me a look that clearly said she was assessing who the real threat here was. The fictional intruder, or the madman installing her alarm system. "It's not bad," he said while my mother collected herself, "but there's holes in your security." "Like what?" my mother asked. Lou led us to the front door and pointed at the motion detector in the living room. "That's your only motion detector," he said. "You've left yourself completely vulnerable. What if I came in through the back door and then I did this?" Lou dropped to his stomach on the kitchen floor. Grunting, he pulled himself, elbow after elbow across the floor until he reached the staircase. I glanced at my mother. "Lou," she began. "Don't look at me," he said. "Look at your motion detector. See how it's not going red?" Lou continued his pursuit up the stairs, elbows banging solidly on the hollow wooden steps. "That's because it doesn't see me." Lou leapt to his feet at the top of the stairs and threw his hands out. "I'm in. I just beat your security system." I was won over. I almost clapped my hands. "Put motion detectors on the second floor," my mother cried. "Someone could bring a ladder." "And come right through your window," Lou said. "Smart lady." 5 years later, Lou's alarm system was put to the test. As it turns out, someone did bring a ladder. They shattered the woefully unprotected window of my old bedroom and for a moment, probably thought they were home free. Probably thought, "Party time," Lou described it. But then they stepped into the hallway and Lou's security lit up the house and the perpetrator fled in 17 seconds. Lou felt like he did his job, and for my mother, it was almost like her whole life had been leading up to that moment. Everything she ever warned us about could in fact actually happen. Sometimes a man will carry a ladder through the woods in the rain and set it right up against her sleeping house. After the break-in, I slept with a can of wasp spray next to my bed. My mother did the same and also kept a set of car keys. Someone tipped her off that setting off your car alarm is a good way to draw attention to the scene of a crime. And the wasp spray was another tip from a fellow cautious citizen. We learned that lots of people live their life in a perpetual state of terror. My mother's next door neighbor suggested she buy what he owns, a deer slayer shotgun. "It's good for beginners," he explained, "because it has a 4-foot shot radius and it's not so long that someone could grab it out of your hand." "That's exactly what I'd be afraid of," my mother told him. The vice principal at the school my mother worked at had a more elaborate idea. They sat down in his office and closed the door. "What you need to do," he said, "is shoot them. Then run down to your kitchen, get a knife, and put it in their hand. That's what you have to do to protect yourself from the law these days. Or after you shoot them, you get a pack of matches, light one up, toss it down, put the pack in his hand, and say he threatened to burn down your house." I don't know if it was comforting for her to know that her boss and neighbor were making plans and packing heat, but I think it did let her know she wasn't alone. And she wasn't wrong to raise me how she did. I lived in Chicago at the time she was robbed, and even as my mother texted me headlines about Chicago street crime and body counts, I like to think that somehow all of this brought us closer together. When we went to bed at night, we knew that somewhere 1,000 miles away, we were both resting our heads on our pillows, looking at that same can of wasp spray and not thinking, "What's that noise?" But instead, "I miss you." Thank you.
Oh, muted again.
We're always muted.
Oh my God, I love that story.
It is so funny. And my mom, who is probably watching and will be mad if I say this, is also very much an alarmist to the point where she gave me, this is something I should write about in the future, but she gave me mace for my car, like, to carry around with me when I lived somewhere else by myself. And I was like, "I don't know about this. This should not be on my keychain. I don't want to mace anybody." And so I shoved it in my glove compartment. And then one day, when I was locked out of my house, I was trying to pry my glove compartment. I thought it had an extra key, but it was stuck, and I was trying to pry it open.
Oh,
and
no.
I found something in my car, like a screwdriver, so I was poking it in the glove compartment, trying to pry it open, and I hit it was like a million degrees out in summer, so this thing was probably ready to burst anyway. But I burst a can of mace inside my own vehicle, wearing contact lenses, with a screwdriver, because my mom was like, "You got to take this mace. You really need it. I'm so worried about you living over there." And so I maced myself with contact lenses in while I was locked out. So.
Oh my God, that's terrible. It's safety gone too far.
They love us, but what are they doing? It's a lot.
Yeah. So thank you so much for having me.
It was so fun.
Of course.
Do you have another date for another Stranger Stories? Do you think you're going to do another virtual?
We're Well, it's just, it's, I was like, I say we, but by habit, but just me now. Oh, I've got to figure that out maybe in August.
Yeah.
And the website's down there below. Yes. If you guys want to check in and find out when the next one will be, once these guys plan it.
Great.
Cool. Well,
thank you guys so much.
Thank you so much.
So nice to see your face.
You too.
Thank you.
Thanks. Bye-bye. Bye.
All right. Well, that was special.
It was so good. Everything. Fallon has the most beautiful delivery. She's such. She's so talented as a writer.
Oh,
but
she's an amazing storyteller, too.
She's an amazing storyteller. Her delivery is just beautiful. It's just perfect.
If you guys do get a chance, please check out one of those events. They are truly amazing. They're a ton of fun. They're funny. They make you cry. They make you laugh.
Oh, yes.
And they're such well-written stories.
Sad stories, funny stories. But Fallon, and she had a partner that did it with her, Judy, who's moving away to go to grad school, I believe. But they just curate it so well. And it's just such an amazing community that she's built.
It really is. So I think what we're going to do is Robin's going to read another poem or two. Mm-hmm. And then I'll play a song. And I think Steve just popped in backstage. And we'll get to Steve. And he's from the Quahogs. And he's going to play a few songs for us. Mm-hmm. All right. What do you got, dear?
I'm going to read a poem that is pretty recent. I wrote it, I think, between our last live stream and now, after working on it for a little bit and getting nervous about writing it or reading it. But it's sort of a piece about feeling like you're two people, and I've always felt like I'm two people until pretty recently. So here's it's called The Double Pulse of a Swallowed Twin. My choices, the two splintery legs of a wishbone, a dead end or a welcome road, the opportunity of a lightning bolt or the shock of an electric fence keeping me in, broken glass at home at the bottom of the sink, or the sound of the ice singing as the frozen lake shatters. My sister and I were raised to think that men do not feel pain. Our too young working class father, surprised by children in his early 20s, let us punch him and bite him, and he did not flinch. Our mechanic grandfather, retired at 40, simmering at home for decades, let us climb the ancient recliner he still sits in and jump on him from above, and he did not flinch. After years of begging you to show your hand, even a single card, you bring your poker face back to my door and tell me you'll always carry me in your pocket. I picture existing in there amongst the screws and bits of wire, destined to destroy our washing machine. And when I scream, you do not flinch.
That's a powerful one.
If that didn't ruin everyone else's night, then I haven't done my job here.
Want to do one more?
I'm going to do one more, and this is a piece about not having enough self-awareness to know when you should make a graceful exit, and it's called Bottle Blonde. You are a permanent resident in a small town of one, living a life made of bills you can't pay, with a home full of things you don't own and ideas that aren't yours, using box dye as currency, overexposed in photos you'll regret, spinning stories no one believes. I can't write off your past, but I've counted your doubts, and I've used your excuses to settle this debt.
That's a powerful one.
Thanks. I wrote it today.
Woo. All right. How about I play a tune, and then we'll tune into Steve?
Let's do that.
Let's do it. Let me grab my guitar.
I'm going to poke out of here and drink my beer on the other side of the room.
Do it. Go.
Don't forget to take down my banner.
Oh, yeah. Thanks, Robin.
You are welcome.
Aw. So, let me move over to this. So, this is always ill-advised, but I've been kind of working on a new tune here, so I thought I'd break this in and see how she sounds and test it out on you guys. So please let me know what you think. Mm-hmm.
the sun had gone to sea. You ran ahead to the hills, I followed you still, your sleeves just out of reach. All the wishes came fast with the dandelion dust, the valley was breathing out. The lonely wind was praying again, chasing all the foxes underground. Tell me now, were we just throwing our pennies into orbit? Tell me now, were we just aimless at best? Oh, the silver just kept growing, but we were holding out for gold. And tell me now, were we just panning riverbeds? I flickered questions in the air. The flames were shouting, you were quiet, counting all it up and barely there. Tell me now, were we just throwing our pennies into orbit? Tell me now, were we just aimless at best? Oh, the silver just kept growing, but we were holding. Tell me now, were we just panning riverbeds? I caught your eyes all wet and wide, now the trees are breathing in. You were another chain reaction, I set off in all directions. An honest insurrection, you always had the upper hand. Tell me now, were we just throwing our pennies into orbit? Tell me now, were we just aimless at best? Oh, the silver just kept growing, but we were holding out for gold. And tell me now, were we just panning riverbeds?
There you go, brand new one. I think it's time to bring in Steve. Steve, you ready back there? Let's see. There he is. What's going on, buddy?
Hey, what's up, mate?
How you doing?
Not much. That was a good song.
Oh, thank you. I appreciate that. How's life? How's life with you?
It's all right. Yeah. Losing it. It's okay.
We all are. You're not alone. I think that's the most important thing to remember. None of us are alone in all of this.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah. You want to play a tune or two for us?
Yeah, sure.
Let's hear it.
All right. This is one off the record that'll come out whenever quarantine's over, I suppose. Fog through the marsh, and I not seen nothing. Hate to see people with their shattered dreams. When will they turn to cinder? The ocean falls to rise, lost the lust and inside your eyes. Were you falling from a cloud while you're talking out loud? High school queen, she just can't seem to see that all highs have ended. Oh, I see Yeah, you're such a kind commodity. Another bender. The ocean falls to rise. Lost the wonder in your eyes. Were you falling from a cloud? Why you're talking out loud?
Buddy, so that's gonna be on the next record.
Yeah, that's gonna be on the new one.
Oh, I cannot wait for that.
Thanks.
Are you guys chipping away at it a little bit, or you're just gonna get into the studio once we're back to some form of normalcy here?
It's basically all done. We just have to do like two more things mix wise, then we're gonna master and do all the production.
Oh, rad! Where'd you record it?
We recorded at Brian Webb's
Nice.
Home. Yeah.
That's awesome. I cannot wait to hear it. So for those of you out there that don't know, this is Stev DelMonico. He is the singer and one of the songwriters for the Quahogs, which is, if you get a chance to see them, they are an amazing band with a ton of energy and a lot of like range. You guys bring it energy-wise. You've got beautiful sad songs. There's a lot of heart in everything that they do, so check them out. You want to play another tune for us?
Yeah, sure. Let's see here. This is from the first record, which is almost 10 years old now. Sunny, let me in. Sunny, stand like a man. Sunny, walk for a while. Holy misguided child. Oh, Sunny, please, why don't you sing it to me? Oh, Sonny, I know that you can. Oh, your girl said a carnival tonight. Stare at her with delight. Sonny, is that the one you love? More than the heavens above. Oh, if it is, why don't you give her a kiss? Said I'd love to, not the one for her. Yeah,
Sunny sits by the bar. He gets up to play some tune. Silence goes across the room. He just met his happily. He says one more round for me. Oh, darling, that should set me straight.
That is a beautiful tune.
Thanks, man. Thanks for having me.
No, of course. You sound great. I miss hearing you in person, but hopefully we'll get back to that in not too long a time, huh?
Yeah. Hopefully soon, man. Likewise.
You think you got one more on you?
Yeah, I could do one more.
I'd love to hear one more, if that's all right.
Yeah, absolutely.
All right.
Let's see. This is another one off the new album. New album is going to be called Tasteless. My throat, you
spin me around. I lost myself. I lost myself. I lost myself. I lost myself.
Yeah, buddy. I've heard you guys play that one live, and it is that's one of my favorite tunes you guys do. Oh, are we starting to lose Steve a little bit?
No.
No.
Not Steve. I can hear him.
I'm playing that song. I think that's my favorite on the album.
Yeah, it's it really is a special one. Well, thanks for joining us, buddy. I think we're
thanks for having me.
Oh, there you are. Yeah, thanks so much for joining us. We'll have to do it again, all right?
That's nice that you guys have been doing this.
Couple weeks, we'll do it again.
Yeah, a couple weeks we'll do it again. We have a lot of fun with it. It's good to see some faces we typically don't get to see. Like yours. So
yeah, I like that, man. Yeah.
So we'll get good together. We'll get together soon. Hopefully we can do a porch beer at some point and share some tunes over a six pack.
I would love that.
All right, buddy. Well, hang in there. We'll talk to you soon, all right? That's Steve DelMonico, everybody, from the Quahogs.
Thanks, Steve.
They got a new record coming out soon. All right. So it's time to scoot over to Dave and Mary, huh? They look like they're backstage. Ready to go?
There they are.
Oh, there they are.
Hi, guys.
Hey. I was just
before going live.
How are you?
Good. Oh, you know what? I got to echo off. Is that better?
Yes.
Perfect. Okay.
How are you guys doing?
Good. How are you?
Oh, hold on. Do you hear an echo?
Not anymore.
No. And if you hear one, it's going to go away as soon as we get off the screen. So it won't bother you while you're playing.
Okay. So I'll just take the headphone. No, I need a headphone so I can hear you. Okay.
So actually, one thing I can do is let me shut this off for a second. Is that helping you a little bit?
One, two. Oh, that's way better. Can you hear us?
Yep.
Yes. Yay. Okay, cool. Is that the audio processing or something?
Yeah, exactly. I had to shut it, turn it back on our end.
How are you guys?
Oh, I didn't know you guys were going to play together. I'm so excited.
We're delighted.
Well, we didn't realize that till I decided.
5 minutes ago.
Half hour, so we
I thought about it and I was like, well, you know, it's pie.
It's me.
You're so gracious to give us, you know, your time and your poems. And thought I should be.
We did ask you if you wanted to play, and you were like, no, Mary should do it. Only Mary. Mary's the performer. So we did ask you, do you want to play? He declined us.
Well, we're glad you undeclined.
I just feel like I don't, music is not my forte. And so I've been trying to avoid it. Oh. And you know, it's you know, I have quarantine face.
Oh, we
know.
All we do. All do. We yeah. all do. Do you look at the beard yeah. right now?
You just shaved him.
I shaved actually
even a week ago.
Yeah, no, that's not true. That's not true. So for anyone who doesn't know, Tim Hiles is one of my very oldest friends since we were teenagers, which I have a better memory of than he does. I did not make as much of an impression on him as he made on me at the time. we lived together here at Castle Blackamore for many years. He was a very nice roommate, made a hell of a mess. didn't clean it up, hated my dog. Didn't want to live with a dog.
Now he's like obsessed with dogs. It's like so funny. It's like a 180. But
In his defense, he didn't know we were getting a dog. who could blame him for holding on to that anger? But we have done so many fun things together over the years. We have traveled to see our favorite bands in locations near and far, including
that's the camera.
Beautiful Flint, Michigan. We spent some time seeing The Promise Ring and many other bands that I loved in my teenage years. I was very quick to get in a car and travel with anywhere with Tim Hiles. So
speaking of Michigan Fest, I just saw there's a hardcore like group on Facebook called Mid-90s.
With the videos, right?
I've seen the videos. I've actually been following them for a while. Someone in that group just posted a photo actually from Michigan Fest from the stage looking down at the crowd. So it's like this huge. And I thought, oh my God, I remember that. And it wasn't the best situation for me.
For any of us. I had a shirt tad and I probably weighed 96 pounds. So nobody looked good. You look good, Tim Hiles.
No, I got left behind by my ride in Michigan.
Tim got left in Michigan.
I don't know, 15 hours, is that something like that?
It was like a 15-hour drive. We drove through Canada when you didn't need a passport. So we were just like zipping through our Arctic neighbor to the north together. And Tim had to ride home in the trunk of my SUV. And I was so scared that we were going to get stopped at the border because I was like concealing a human body. And we weren't drinking. No one drank. We didn't even drink yet in life. But I had Tim in the trunk of my car. And I was like,
you didn't know that.
There was cool, Hiles.
There was a bunch of like stuff sort of like hiding me. And everyone's
luggage.
Just lean down. Like
compress yourself. Can you become smaller? So we've had so many adventures. And now Tim and Mary are joining us from the West Coast. They're in Los Angeles.
Yep. Yep. I don't know how much longer, but
see.
Yeah. We may be making our way back to Rhode Island soon. Ooh.
Oh, a surprise announcement.
Yeah. Not like we can hang out or anything, but like, you know, we'll be near you.
Our live stream will be from a shorter distance.
Yeah. So you guys going to play a few tunes for us?
Yeah.
Just the entire Auburn back catalog, correct?
Yeah, totally.
I made you a necklace.
Stop. Or don't stop. I loved that song when I was a teenager.
So cute.
I don't get it, but it's okay.
My response song to that is I made you a carrot cake that you didn't want.
Nope. Carrot cake, cheesecake. Ugh.
You know what? You had it good over here in my vegan palace. But now you have it better with Mary, what her new cooking project that you told me all about.
He lives at Marini's.
I haven't even told BJ about it yet, but I'll tell you later. It's so funny. I thought it was real and I was like, damn, this stuff looks good. No, it's a fake Facebook account.
So funny.
It's really funny.
Well, play us a song. We're happy to see you. We're happy to listen.
So you want me to play first?
Yeah, if you want. Or what do you want to start with?
Yeah. Okay, that's fine. Sure.
Whatever. Either one.
Put the reverb there.
All right.
Okay, this is a song I wrote, I don't know, 10 years ago, maybe. I went to a bar and there was a guy who was at the bar and he, you can play some background music.
Sure.
And, it was a karaoke bar, of course. And I was talking to him and I had we just got to talking, and he told me that he was actually from Mexico, but he was stuck in the U.S. He didn't have any way, passport, or anything to get back into the country. And he'd been in the U.S. for, I don't know, 15, 20, 30 years or something like that. And all of his brothers at that point had died. He was an older guy, sort of in the 70s, maybe 80s. And I felt so bad about this guy never getting to even say goodbye to those people that, you know, his family that passed on. And sort of also kind of made me think about my own mortality. And so this song, not to sound morose in this time, but I just like this song and I know it. So that's why I'm gonna play it. It's one of the few songs I remember how to play. No one to greet me when I come home. I'm used to the quiet, I'm warm to the cold. Oh, my brothers have left this place,
gone home
to the black infinite space. We bettered our lives, and even though I survived, I'm not sure I won this race. Now I'm looking at the big sky
again,
wondering when it's my time to fly. And I know I'll miss my friends like Robin Pye, all the ones I love, and I'll be looking down from above.
Oh, that was beautiful.
Tim Hiles. Classic Tim Hiles, never giving himself any credit. What you have Mary for.
Well, she makes, she's what makes the music 20,000 times better. I keep looking down here, but I realize the camera's up there.
It's hard to be like looking at you guys.
Aw. You guys have another tune for us?
We do, and we're going to let Mary sing this one.
Woo!
Yeah. The more far superior.
Oh my
voice.
God,
stop. Oh, stop.
No, it's just not used to playing, so the calluses have gone away from my fingers. So, yeah. Do you want to do another one? Or
yeah, please.
Okay.
Here, I'll pop up.
I'll just keep it like this.
Yeah, that's fine.
Yeah. Check 1, 2. Sorry.
Waiting as the moments pass in the silence, hoping you'll come to me. Hope and you still love me. Da 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 da. Walking down the sidewalk tonight, giants like diamonds. And I wish that you could see. I wish you were here with me. Da 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 da. Is our chance we can If we need to, then we can just take it slow. We'll take it slow.
Oh, that was a beautiful song.
Thank you.
So nice to hear you guys play together.
Thanks. It's fun to play together, so thanks for making this happen. Otherwise, it wouldn't.
Yeah, I don't really... I prefer to let the professional handle.
Music is about fun anyway, so it's
not... True story.
Yeah.
Karaoke is about fun.
Karaoke is definitely about fun.
I don't know that anybody should perform karaoke at a place where Mary is also performing karaoke, though. Mary's like the person you hate to see at karaoke. Oh. It sounds good, and everyone's here to make fun of everyone. So
I'll take that as a compliment.
Yes. It's no one should perform karaoke after you, Mary.
Oh, well, you took this off. Sorry. Thank you.
It's true. It's true.
Do you guys have one more for us, maybe?
We didn't prepare one, but is there anything you know offhand? Do you want to do Angel or something?
Oh, yeah, actually, that would be appropriate. Yeah, okay.
One more?
Sure.
Let's do it.
Sure, I'll leave the turn that to the echo off.
Oh, okay.
So this is actually a John Prine song, which he's been, unfortunately, one of the victims from COVID-19, which sucks. This is a song that Mary and I have played for a long time. So it was a bit heartbreaking to play it recently, still fresh. But anyway, it's like his music lives on. And so I think I'm actually happy to play this. Yeah.
The chord?
Yeah. I'll give you a second here.
Make me an angel, but yours. Right. We didn't practice this one.
Yeah, sorry. Make me an angel that flies from Montgomery. Make me a poster of an old rodeo. Just give me one thing that I can hold on to believe in this living. It's just a hard way to go.
Love and hold on me, that I can hold on to believe in this living is just a hard way to go.
When I was a young girl, I had me a cowboy. You weren't much to look at, just a free rambling man. But that was a long time, and no matter how I tried, the years just flow by like a broken down dam. Make me an angel that flies from Montgomery. Make me a poster of an old rodeo. Just give me one thing that I can hold on to believe in this living is just a hard way to go.
There's flies in the kitchen, I can hear them, they're buzzing. Really is. And I ain't done nothing since I woke up today.
Now how in the hell can a person go to work in the morning, come on home in the evening, and have nothing? Make me an angel that flies from Montgomery. Make me a poster of an old Romeo. Just give me one thing that I can hold on to believe in this living is just a hard way to go.
To believe in this living is just a hard way to go. And that, my friends,
get a room. I love you.
Thank you. Thank you for joining us.
Oh, that was beautiful.
Thanks for having us. We miss you guys.
Yeah, we miss everybody. I mean, I think everybody's feeling the same, but it feels weirder to be 3,000 miles away from everybody.
Yeah,
I know. I sent you a card and you didn't open it for over 3 weeks.
At least there's a quarantine period for mail.
I know.
but yep. Right now we have it hanging up on the mirror in the bedroom because it makes us happy.
Positive reinforcement every day. Yes. Who knows what I was complaining about in that letter I sent you.
It was really sweet.
Well, thanks for joining us. Hopefully we could do it again.
Thank you guys so much.
Anytime. Yeah. Thank you so much. For sure.
I love you guys. Take care.
Chance to hear something by John Prine.
Yeah.
By you guys is definitely a perfect opportunity. So thank you guys so much for sharing.
Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you for having us on.
See you soon.
Okay.
All right. Bye.
Bye.
All right, friends. So we're getting towards the end here. I think I just want to, before we finish up and Robin reads a couple pieces and I sing a couple songs, I just want to make sure we give thanks to Evan, Captain Bunny Dangerfingers.
Amazing.
For popping in earlier.
Who's and obviously live streaming from the basement of the New Orleans Jazz Museum with the saxophones and blue lights on in the background. We don't know where he is or why he's there, but he's doing it.
And then Greg Bouchard and Fallon Masterson, the power couple, joining in and sharing some amazing songs and
an really, amazing story.
Really funny, perfect story. And then Stev DelMonico from the Quahogs popped in. Oh, Brian Oakley.
Brian
Oakley from Pizza J and Julian's
letting us know. Owner of two of everybody's favorite establishments in the city.
No. And you'll be on his live stream on Tuesday.
I'm going to be on his PMA, so I have to learn how to fake some PMA by Tuesday. I'm looking forward to talking about something with him on Tuesday night.
And then thanks to David / Tim and Mary for popping in at the end there. So we're going to close it out with a couple poems. Mm-hmm. What you got?
You pulled back up here so I can see the screen.
Oh, right.
Can't trust this guy.
Nope.
So I'm going to read a piece of, I wrote about one of my other oldest friends, one of my former roommates. And we used to spend a lot of time going out together and we would play a game called Good Drink, Bad Drink. And we would go to the worst possible bar that we could find. And we would drink the worst possible drink that they had available, whether it was a beer no one's ever heard of or a cocktail that they would serve us when we asked for the worst drink they had. And then we would go to a nice bar and we would have a good drink and we would alternate that until it was time to go home. And my favorite time that we did that, we showed up at Trinity Brew House at last call and asked the bartender Seth for a top shelf margarita at closing time, to which he said, fuck you. So, not a drink that they're known for. So this is called My Baby Still Smokes. You are up all day, circling the little city, supplying snow day champagne to east side shut-ins. And we are up all night, circling each other, telling 12-year-old secrets, trading 20-year-old love songs, and our matching sweaters with our made-up rules, saving the best for last call. Maybe one more?
Yeah. Keep them coming.
I only have so many. I'm not as prolific as you. I'm going to read something new that I wrote last week called The Bus You Rode In On. The Bus You Rode In On. 12 times we filled up the car and pushed a pin into the map, silenced the ringing phone in search of security and a soft landing. Sleepless for 6 months, we stayed up negotiating, digging until we hit gasoline, practicing our vows and promising to bury the boxes. We've cleaned out the basement, thrown dishes like frisbees, built what we wanted, and put her to rest on the curb.
I like it.
You would.
I like it.
I think that's it.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. So I'm going to grab my guitar and I'll play a couple tunes and then you'll come back and we'll say goodnight to everybody.
We're running a little bit over, but it's because we have so many people that we love that we're so happy to see. So,
true story.
Yeah, I'm going to climb out of here.
Don't trip over the pug.
Impossible.
Oh. There it is. There it is. All right. I might play two or three tunes to close us out here. I start with an old tune that I wrote called Adeline. Okay, you know what? Before I do that, I gotta turn this thing off. Rookie mistake. There we go.
Scrape this blood from my hands. Oh, how I've paid for another man. been since. Rid me of this protest and all these visions in my sleep. Won't you please forgive me? Feel the shakes in the road. Pothole after pothole, it's time I fill my soul with the shape I'm in. Better go find me a little faith. They won't you please forgive me? Yeah, oh, it comes in waves. Guilt follows you down and it leaves no trace. Yeah, oh, it comes in waves. When the moon is down, I still see your face. As if I'd done the wrong myself, oh, Adeline. As if I'd done the wrong myself, oh, Adeline. Taste the fog. Every knock on the door means something's gone wrong. The whole damn world's on fire. Oh Lord, we could use a little grace. Yes. Oh, Adeline, won't you please forgive?
A tune called Adeline. So what do I want to play next?
You know what you want to play next.
I don't know.
What do I want you to play next?
We're getting that one. We've got a request for the Bee Gees over here. I will play the Bee Gees after this, I promise. First I'm going to play a tune called I'm going to play the lantern before we get to the Bee Gees. I think that's what I should do. Wake me when you get there, little darling.
call me if you remember my name. In the darkest corners of my mind, your name still brings a light. How I wish I could do for you the same. Your voice is growing faint now, little darling. Must be bouncing off the years in between. But if I climb to the top of town, oh, I can swear you're calling out somewhere far beyond the evergreens. If I call to you, can you still hear me? Or are you listening? How do you remember me? There was a rat within the kitchen back then. Or are you listening? My doubt thicker than a tree. That's how it used to be back then. Back then.
A tune called The Lantern. Last time we did this live stream, we've got a music video that's ready to go. We gave a sneak peek to that one. So hopefully on the other end of all of this, we'll be able to release the record that we've been working on, which is just about done, and release that music video to the public for everybody to see. Or maybe it'll make a sneak appearance at some point at a future stream. But I've got one more for you, if I remember how to play it, because it's been a little while. I like to throw in one maybe unsuspecting cover when we do these, and Robin had heard me play this Bee Gees tune once before and has been asking me to play it again. Say what you will about the Bee Gees, but this is a beautiful song.
What good could it be if I ain't got you. If I ain't got you. Oh, there's a way, yes. Everybody says do each and every little thing. What good does it bring if I ain't got you? If I ain't got you. And baby, you don't know what it's like. Baby, you don't know what it's like to love somebody. Love somebody the way I love you. Oh, in my brain, yes, I see your face again. I know my frame of mind ain't got to be so unkind. Have I grown blind? So, 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 so very blind. Baby, I'm a man. Can't I see what I am? I live and breathe for you. What good does it do if I ain't got you? If I ain't got you. And baby, you don't know what it's like. Baby, you don't know what it's like to love somebody, to love somebody. And baby, you don't know what it's like. Baby, you don't know what it's like to love somebody. Love somebody the way I love you. And the way I do. There it is. The Bee Gees, to love somebody. Well, live from...
Change of plans. I'm going to read one... more.
Oh, please.
We got to pull up my website here so I can read it.
We got a request.
I'm going to read this one.
Okay.
But can you also make it so I can see us?
I
need technology assistance here.
Of course. It's a rarity that that's something I can offer.
You can offer so much. So I am very excited that so many of our friends have tuned in. People we haven't seen in so long or heard from in so long. People that are not even people that we talk to on like a daily basis. Like our friends on other coasts and our friends in faraway states. So, but I am very excited that one of my friends has finally joined us. Apparently he's been watching for a little while. But my buddy Sean is here, and he has been very encouraging to me this entire time and is really part of the reason I started submitting to so many poetry journals, because every time I posted something on my A Little Broken Glass Instagram account, he would say, do something with this, or publish, and I would say, I don't want to, and he would say, publish, and I would say, I will try. And so he has joined us, and I'm going to read a poem that he liked. That I posted a while back, and I did read it last week, but he was busy doing his antiquing life where he travels to different states and sells people really weird stuff. And I hope that in a future live stream, he'll join us and talk about some of the weird stuff he's been up to. So I'm going to read Scheduled Demolition for Sean. Scheduled Demolition. You see me. You see me with my bag of broken tools, spinning loss into gold, spinning bone into clouds, spinning time into blood. Suddenly, everyone is a mason with opinions on what I should do with these bricks. Use them to build a new bedroom, soft sheets, dark walls, or use them to entomb the bodies in the basement, up against the wall in the wine cellar, secure behind layers of misery and cold mortar. You say I'm your favorite constellation, all teeth and eyes. My favorite constellation. You and I whispering, shoes off, at the two addresses I consider home, studying blueprints of broken glass and discolored granite. Breathing in place for 200 years before we met, those lonely columns have seen it all. Dragged 12 miles into place by horse and carriage, paraded through town before the invention of electricity. A sure sign of success in the new city center, where we dredged the river and built a bank. We're in a hurry to bulldoze the years and build a foundation, desperate to put down lines. My blood mixed with yours at the bottom of a legal document. Let's bury it. Let's bury it. I'll bury it.
That's a special one. Thank you. And thanks, Sean.
Yeah.
It takes a lot for us artists to feel comfortable enough to share what we do and be encouraged to create more. So for all of you out there, thank you guys for joining us. Thanks to Sean and everybody that has tuned in to support everybody that they've heard tonight.
Yes, thank you.
So we'll probably do another one of these in a couple weeks.
2 weeks.
Yeah, so keep your eyes on the prize and tune in back then, and we'll hopefully see you all there. But thank you guys for joining us so much.
Thank you.
Stay safe. Have a good night. There it is. Bye.